Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I make a bunch of videos about Salesforce because I love Salesforce. I don't know if you can see it, but in my viewfinder I have like this cool rainbow in the background. I don't know if it's gonna show up, but it is really cool right now. Today we're going to be going over how I personally prepare for Salesforce cert. I did a video about how I am going to prepare for the advanced admin cert, but I didn't want to make this video because I feel like this video could be really useful about how I go about studying for a Salesforce cert, and I've kind of practiced and refined this process by working with my husband, who is a 10-time certified Salesforce architect, and this is kind of what I have seen is very, very helpful. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into it. Okay, so the first step is I research the certification, if it's a certification that I am personally going to find useful, if I am going to find it is not too difficult for me to get, and if I find that, at least for me personally, that I can make useful content for you guys from it. Or that it'll help me further my career. One thing that I'm not too interested in is CPQ, because it can be really monotonous, and the certification is extremely hard, and there are not good study materials out there, if I'm being honest. And so it is very, like, if you do not have a year of experience on the CPQ, then it's gonna be very, very difficult for you to pass this certification. Just point blank. Whereas other certifications, you don't necessarily have to have years and years of experience on it, on the platform, working on the platform. And how I usually go about doing this is I'll go on to the Trailhead website and look at the certification and kind of decide if it's something, a part of Salesforce I'm interested in, and look at the study guide, see if I have any knowledge that has crossed over from other certifications or other experience I have gotten on the Salesforce platform. So that is step number one. Step number two is I will usually, if I choose to go with the certification, I will usually look on Reddit to see if what other people recommend. I find Reddit is a really good place for this because people are willing to share what really helped them go from maybe not passing to passing on a certain certification. And so people I've found have been really generous with the information they're willing to give on what materials are good, what materials are bad. So I usually check there and I'll write down all the different materials they recommend for that certification. Right, and after I have looked at Reddit for the materials, I will also in tandem look for study guides. So this is going to be on the different blogs around Salesforce. This could be Salesforce Ben, Salesforce 99, or SFDC 99 by David Liu. Other websites, post on Twitter if you can't Google find any. People are really generous on Twitter as to what has helped them get their certifications. So if you can't find the good blog study guides, then go ahead and do that. And while this is going on, I am compiling a list of all these different study materials. If it's a study guide from a company, a consulting firm, or if it is a series of videos on YouTube, I'm compiling this into a huge list of to-dos that I'm going to go through all these materials. Okay, and then number four is I will compile a list of Trailhead modules. Generally, each Salesforce certification has a trail mix as far as the different badges and projects that you can do to prepare and to help, as well as documentation from Salesforce on the specifics that you will be tested on. So I will also add that to my study list. And then next is going to be YouTube resources. I like to start with the free resources before I jump into a paid resource. A lot of people are very generous with their free resources. I'm making a free resource for you right now on my YouTube channel. So definitely check out YouTube videos on the specific subjects. So let's say you were studying communities. You'd want to find a YouTube channel or a series of YouTube videos on the basics of communities and learn as much as you can from those. And so those are about the exhaustive list of the free resources that I will use. After this, I will usually try and find a course on Udemy. I have courses on Udemy. I love Udemy. I've taken many courses on Udemy. It's a great way to get, one, cheap courses, cheap materials, and help support another person on the platform. So, and not all certifications will have a resource on Udemy. Many of them do, but many of them also do not. So if you can't find a good resource about it on Udemy, then maybe you should make one. And then finally, another great one is going to be Focus on Force. They often have both study questions as well as study guides that go through documentation, all the different concepts, a study guide that's more in detail. There are a few different types of study guides. I should have explained this earlier, but the study guides are usually going to be either a list of resources that they've used, or they're going to be a lot of documentation and concepts on the Salesforce platform. Again, try and find, I think Focus on Force is the best place for practice questions, but if you cannot find any on Focus on Force, then other platforms will typically have practice questions. One thing to look out for with practice questions is that they give you the Salesforce documentation as to why each question answer is correct or incorrect. I find this, for me, to be extremely helpful, and it also validates their questions, so then you know that you can learn from your mistake as well as they know what they're talking about. All right, and then after I've gathered a list of all these resources and put them in order, exactly how I have just laid it out, and I will put this in the description as well. So it's usually going to be the study guide materials, then it's going to be Trailhead modules, YouTube videos, it's going to be courses on Udemy and Focus on Force. What I like to do is I start out with the first one and I start going through it, reading it, understanding these concepts, and I will take down vigorous notes as well as write down any questions that I have. And before I move on to the next study material, so let's say I have found a really great study guide, before I move on to a YouTube video, I will answer every single question that I have written down about that specific part of Salesforce. Move on until I've answered those well enough to be able to explain to someone else. And a bonus tip, at least for how I learn, is if I can explain a part of Salesforce to someone else in a somewhat reasonable fashion, then I am going to be 10 times more likely to remember that concept on the exam than if I had just read it 5 times and went forward without creating any materials. So that could be helpful for you. If you are a person that likes to write or make YouTube videos, then definitely by all means try that out. That is why I created this YouTube channel, that's why I created a blog. Yeah, it is extremely helpful. And then once I am able and have gone through all of these different resources, going through, taking vigorous notes, answering the questions, moving on to the next resources, taking notes, answering questions, gone through all the resources, I will take a practice exam, and depending on the score of that practice exam, if there are any available, then I will either review the concepts that I did poorly on, or I will go ahead and take the test. Usually, I like a 15% margin between the passing score of the certification and the score I got on the practice exam. So let's say passing is 65%, I like to have an 80%, maybe even 90% to feel comfortable taking that exam. So that is my extensive process in going through trying to get a Salesforce certification. I hope that this was at all helpful. If it was, be sure to like this video, subscribe, and yeah, I will catch you in the next one. Bye.